Hello, you guys. Welcome to my channel and welcome to another Confessions of a Paper Addict Cutfiles Design Team Layout. I have another release for you this month that was from July of last year. There was just a few cutfiles that I cut right away because I really wanted to use them, and this is one of them. So these are the tropical fish. They're super fun. I don't have a collection picked out yet, but I'm sure I can find something bright and colorful to back these all with. So I'm going to get to backing my fish, pick out some photos, and then we'll show you what I can create with this cutfile. Okay, I have backed my cute fish, and I ended up finding heart eyes from Simple Stories. I had it kind of laying on my desk. So I used this collection, one, like I said, because it was on my desk, two, because since I did the black outline, I really wanted some really bright fish, and I thought the colors in this collection were perfect. So I did some of them, kind of the rainbow stripe. I did the smiley face paper on some of them. So I have, I'll show you what I have. This one's I Heart You, so it's got smiley face paper and then the rainbow stripe. This one was Love Notes. It had this beautiful paper there that I cut apart, and then You Plus Me on the back, but it's this beautiful bright pink. And then I have, this was the journal element, so I used I didn't use as much of this, but I used a little bit of this, and ended up only cutting out a couple because I liked some of these journaling bits that I thought maybe I could use. But I've got that because I grabbed these photos of my niece when we were at the aquarium, and I thought it would be perfect. We're actually at the zoo, and so we're at the aquarium part. And I thought her surrounded by fish would just be perfect. So I'm going to trim these down and mat them. And then I think I've got one of my Scrapping Reflections stencils from the Stencil of the Month Club that I haven't used yet. When I haven't used them, I leave them on my desk. I still haven't used. I think this was the January one? Yes, I think this was the January one. I haven't used, I think it's the December one yet, because it's stars, and I just haven't done a lot of star layouts. But I think we're going to use this to kind of create a background. I've got some cardstock. I do have a few floral embellishments here. Not a ton, but I do have a few. But I think we're going to do some stenciling with some blues, maybe some tending to the pinks and greens. I'm not sure, but I thought I would do that on this white cardstock, I think on the smooth side. And then I think I might mat it in this black just to have something, or I might even mat it on like a pattern paper that I can find that's maybe like a deep blue or a turquoise or something. So yeah, I just want to mat it somehow. So let me trim this down. I'm going to trim my photos, I'm going to mat them, and then I'm going to get all my colors picked out, and we will start stenciling. Okay. I just did a thin black mat after I trimmed my photos down. I'm going to stack them kind of close because after all, it's her face that you want, not necessarily the glass, but yeah. So I've grabbed mostly kind of turquoisey colors, and I'm just using, I need more. I'm just using my Pink and Main blending brushes just because I thought with this stencil having all these moving parts that these would be better. And I've got a hair underneath. And we might spritz with a little bit of something too, but I wanted to get these waves. Maybe no brush is going to work. Let me just see what one of these ones does. Okay, maybe these are gonna be the key. Just kidding, not using my Pink and Main one. But they're all in the same color family, so I don't need to worry too much about brushes and changing them, but I have a big rainbow of them, so you might as well use them. And then I don't have to worry about cleaning between just in case, so we don't any brush is gonna move all my waves here. This is definitely one of those stencils that are better for sprayed mixed media, but I'm determined to do some of this. So I decided to use a few distress oxides, mostly in the teal, aqua, but soft family, because when I held my swatches up to it, that's kind of what it gave me. So I'm just gonna do a little bundled sage here and there. I've got, doing speckled egg right now. I've got evergreen bough and then a little cracked pistachio. That's probably the brightest one out of all of them. But I kind of laid out my fish and my photos on my paper before I took, before I got my inks out, just to kind of see a layout that I liked and was finding a good composition. I grabbed this paper. Was it Craft Consortium? I don't remember. I have like a paper pad of all these kinds, and it looks really cool just because I wanted a really dark edge, because I was gonna maybe matte with the black, but I decided I wanted a little bit of color. And right now this might look like nothing, but when we remove the stencil, it'll look even better. And it'll kind of blend some of them together. Or maybe I even do it off the stencil. Yeah, that might be cool. Okay, let's see what the stencil looks like. It's looking pretty neat. Right, let's do some blobs. It's kind of getting the look I wanted. We'll let that dry, and I think I'm also going to add some splatters. Well, blue me darn, is that gonna be too blue? Might be. Maybe ocean water, because I love it. I think it's my favorite. Ooh, that was open. That would've been bad. While we're still wet, we'll... the background, like, I start getting an idea. So while this dries, I'm gonna go search for things to execute that idea, and then I'll show you that in here in a second. Okay. So I've glued my photos and my fish down. I popped this guy up on foam. I went and kind of raided my Elf Studio bucket, actually. Like, there was more things in there than just Elf Studio, but there was a lot of things from there that were the right colors. So I have some things from a couple kits that I got that match perfectly, so I don't really need to use some of the embellishments that I had from Simple Stories, which is kind of nice. But what I thought about doing, and they're kind of turning out, but the hearts are kind of the wrong shape. They'd be cuter if they were fatter hearts, so it's not looking as good as I thought it would, but they're still kind of cute. So they're fish hearts. So you just layer two hearts together. This is the back fin and this is the body. I drew a little eye on them. I think I'm gonna do just a couple more, just to kind of like really like push that idea. But yeah, and then I'm just drawing an eyeball on them, so you can tell it's a fish. Even though I really can't still, but it's fine. That one looks angry. from Vicky Booten, I believe. Yep. I just gotta figure out where to put that. Okay, and then there was one more thing I wanted to get. And that's these sparkly effervescents from Spiegel Mom Scraps. They're like clear little bubbles. So I'm gonna sprinkle those around and I'm gonna move this. I just don't know where to put it yet. I'm gonna sprinkle those around, move that around, and you guys will get some close-ups, but I appreciate you. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure you check out the new website and the Facebook group for inspiration and all that good stuff. I appreciate you guys. Thank you very much. And we'll see you next time.